Good morning, children. How are you all? Hope you all are safe at home. So in last class, we have learned the editing of select contents in MS Excel 2010. So today we are going to learn about formatting data in MS Excel 2010. Formatting is nothing but we are changing the appearance to present our worksheet attractively. Suppose if you want to display in different colors. So for one column one color, for subject one color, and for S name one color, S number one color. You can present it attractively by giving the different background colors and by changing different handwriting, different sizes, and by giving different colors for the text background and for the text also. So that comes under text format. And next one, you can align the text. Whatever the data you enter into the cell, that you can align in different directions. So suppose to the left side or to right side or to the center, top, bottom, middle, like that you can align the text in the cell. And next one, you can give colors, and you can give the indent. So you can give the space between the border and the text. So you can increase it and you can decrease it. And you can display the text in different orientations. That means upward directions or downward directions. You can align the text in different directions using orientation. So all this we will learn today. So what is formatting? The presenting our worksheet attractively. That means making changes to our text by giving different colors, background colors, and changing the handwritings and size, and aligning them and giving different orientations. And one more, wrap text and wedge and center also we will learn today. These alignment, orientation, text format, these three we will learn today. Remaining we will learn in next class. Okay, what is our lesson name? Formatting data in MS Excel 2010. Suppose if you want to display some first class students in one color, second class students in another color, second grade, like that. You can give different colors. You can present your worksheet attractively so that it increases the readability to the user. If you present it, so it will be the attractive and it increases the readability. So by seeing that, they will know what is what and which is in which color. So it differentiates between the columns. Okay? So like that you can give different colors and you can give the you can align the text in different formats. Formatting data. Data is nothing but the facts and figures. It may be the text, it may be the number. Letters or numbers, whatever you enter, that is called as data. Formatting data in MS Excel 2010. We know that MS Excel, it contains the spreadsheet or worksheet we call it. In that it has rows and columns. We have to create the column names for a table. And according to that column name, we have to enter the records. Data we have to enter, the total row is called as record. All this we have learned in previous class. Okay. So suppose in this, how we can increase the presentation, how we can increase the appearance of the worksheet by aligning. Alignment. So in this we have horizontal alignment. Horizontal alignment. So in this horizontal alignment we can align the text to top and middle. Middle to bottom. So in three directions we can align the text horizontally. Top means, suppose example, if you take this cell, if you give top means you enter whatever the data you enter, that will be in the top position. So here we will give S number. Suppose I give the column names must and should you have to give. Okay, S number here, only one column I am taking example. So here I entered 1. If you give the top alignment, it comes here. Okay, next one. If you give middle, it is displayed in the middle. If you give the bottom alignment, it is displayed here. Like that, the position, the place, that position will be changed whatever the alignment you select. So next is vertical alignment. So in vertical alignment, we can align the text to left side, right side, and center. Second one is vertical alignment. So in this vertical alignment, we can align the text to left side and align the text to right side, and we can align the text in center. Same example will take S number here 1. Okay, so left means to the left side it will be displayed, and right means to very right side it is displayed. Suppose if you select center, it is displayed in the center. So this is the vertical alignment. So in this alignment, we have another orientation. Next is orientation. So in orientation, we have different directions. We can align the text in different directions. Align text up, align text down, clockwise, anti-clockwise. So these directions we can change, clockwise, anti-clockwise. So these are the different orientations we can give to our text. Okay, like this. So suppose this is the cell here. So align text up means it will be displayed in up direction. Align text down means the text will be displayed in downward direction. So clockwise, anti-clockwise, like that it will be displayed. Next is this indent. One more is indent. So in the indent, we can increase the indent and we can decrease the indent. We can increase and we can decrease the indent. Indent means the space, this gap between the border of the cell and the text. So this is the border of the cell, and here this is the text. The gap, this gap will be increased and this gap will be decreased by using this indent. Increase and we can decrease the space between the border and the text. So next one is, so alignment, orientation, indent. So these three comes under alignment. So next is formatting. Text format. Text format. So in this text format, we can give different fonts, different sizes. So font means here handwriting. Different handwritings we can give, different sizes we can give, and colors. For text and background. For text we can give the color, and for background of the cell, background of cell also we can give different colors. Colors, size, handwriting, size, color we can give in this text format. That means we are increasing the appearance of the text by giving different sizes, different handwritings, and by giving background color and foreground color. Foreground means text color, background means cell background color. And we can make it as bold, italic, underline. Suppose you only have headings, that time you will give some underline for that. Or if you want to display in a slanting mode, italic, some records if you want to display like that, you can use italic. For bold, the column headings you can give bold. So these are the font styles. So this is bold, italic, and underline. So these three we can give as font styles. This comes under text formatting. Next, we have two topics, wrap text and wedge and center. So what are those? We will learn now. So next is wrap text. Wrap text means, suppose if we have a big sentence, so long sentence you have. So that sentence is not fitting one cell. So if you use this wrap text, all the sentence will be displayed in multiple lines in single cell. Suppose if you write Prati Vidyaniketan, example. Okay. So like this we can, if you write like this. So is it fit in one cell? No, the cell will be like this only. Isn't it? So here if you write, it won't fit in this single cell. If you use wrap text, that single sentence, that sentence will be displayed in multiple lines. Like this, in multiple lines it will be displayed in one single cell. Like this it will be displayed in one single cell. Okay, that is wrap text. The long sentences are displayed in multiple sentences in one single cell. Okay, like that. One more is merge and center. Merge and center. So merge and center means, again we will take that same example. Prati Vidyaniketan. Same example we will take. Okay, this also not fit in one single cell. But you can select three or more cells. That means the how many cells you want, those cells you have to select. And you can use this merge and center. Click on that. So these cells will be combined and this sentence will be displayed in the center, in the middle. So after that you can give different colors or handwritings, styles, sizes, you can give. You can apply for that. And styles also, bold, italic, underline, styles also, you can apply for that. Merge and center means more than one cell. Our cell are merged. And whatever the text, whatever the sentence you give, that will be displayed in the middle of that space. Whatever you select, how many cells you want to merge. Merging means combining. Two or three cells combining together and displaying the text in the middle, in the center. Okay, this you can use for headings. If you want to give headings, classics, student details or some school employee details. If you want to give headings before column names, for that we can use this merge and center. Okay children, so today we have learned alignment, orientation and index, text format and this wrap text and merge and center. Okay, remaining part we will learn in next class. I will show you all this practically in the system so that you can understand and remember better. And practice the examples. At least you can store your friends' details. And apply these formatting, apply these changes, appearances, appearance to change that appearance of your table by giving different handwritings, colors, font colors, making it bold, italic, underline, using wrap text, merge and center. Like that, create one table and practice at home. Okay, children?
Yeah, good morning children. Today we are going to learn about formatting in MS Excel 2010. Okay, formatting means we are changing the appearance, isn't it, to present it attractively and for readability we are using this formatting. So formatting is nothing but we are aligning the text or giving different orientations to the text and we are giving the font, color, sizes, different handwritings and we are giving different colors to the text. Okay, so now we will see that. So all this you will find on the home tab. Here it, this is the home tab. We'll go back. See, this one is home tab. So on this home tab, we will find all this. This one, different handwritings here. See text format. So these are different handwritings, and here you can increase the size or decrease the size. This one to increase font size, decrease the font size, and you can fill the background color for the cell, and you can give the different colors for the text. So change the color of your text. This is bold, italic, underline. So these all comes under text format. Using these you can format the text. That means how you can format the text by using different handwriting, different hand sizes, and using the styles bold, italic, underline, and giving background color and giving the text color. So this comes under text formatting. So next here you'll see the top align, see middle align, so bottom align. So and next one align left, align center, align right. So these comes under alignment. You can align means you can change the position of the text in the cell, in which direction you want to move it, in which direction you want to display that, either it is left side or right side or center of the cell, you can display the text. So this is alignment. And this one is orientation. Orientation means in different directions you can display the text. We'll see those. See angle counterclockwise, angle clockwise, vertical text, rotate text up, rotate text down, format cell alignment. So all these you can use. That means in that direction this text whatever you type that will be displayed. Okay. Next is wrap text. So if you use wrap text, the long text will be displayed in multiple lines in one single cell. Suppose if you write one big sentence which is not fit in this cell. Example, Pragati Vidyaniketan, you will write. All that sentence, that word is not fit in one cell. So if you use wrap text, so that sentence will be displayed in multiple lines. See here, like this, in one cell. And merge and center. So that same example, that word is not fit in the cell, so we can use the merge and center, then it will merge 2-3 cells. These cells it will merge, and whatever the text you give, that is displayed in the center of the cells. This is merge and center. Okay, next one is indent. Decrease indent, increase indent. So your decrease indent means it will decrease the space between this border and the text, and increase indent means it will increase the space between this text and the border. Okay, so all this comes under formatting. So till text formatting we will learn in this part. Remaining number format and cell styles, all those we will learn in next class. Okay, so this handwriting, sizes, color, bold, italic, underline under text format, and these are alignment to top, bottom, right, middle, center. This comes under alignment, and this one is orientation. In this orientation, next increase the indent, decrease indent, and one more is wrap text and merge text. So till here we will learn today. So how to do all this practically, I'll show you now. First we will enter one record. Okay, column names must and should. You have to enter the column names. According to that column name only we have to enter the text. That is must and should. Without column names you can't enter the records. That means what you are entering you should know, and others should know. That's why we have to write the column names. It is a table, means it should have the column names. After that it should have the data according to that column. Okay, so first one we will write one example table here. After that we will apply one after one and we will check those. Okay, so now we will type. So here we will give different handwritings. See this one, which one, any one handwriting, whichever, whatever you want to write, whatever you like, that you can select here. Okay, I am selecting this. And here size, which size we want, that size also we can select. So 18 I am selecting. Color, for this font color also we can change, no? That color I am selecting here. See, with that color the text is displayed. So after writing also you can select all those, or before writing also we can select it. The handwriting like this. You can use tab to go to other cells. So like this you can give the space. See, you can drag like this, this one. Okay, like that we can write. Now we will change the color. The size also we can change to 14. A color, another color we will take. S number 1. Okay, after typing we will change everything once. Class 6, section 3. I'm writing one letters. Okay, you can write whatever you want. So this one again. B. So here I wanted 2 records. See, select it and you can change the color like this. Or handwriting, size, everything you can change. See, the changes are, you can see the changes are not here, different handwritings, isn't it? So like this, this one. Now you can display the text in different colors. So and again we will give the background color, another background color. See this one, like this. And for these records also we will give another color. See, colors are changed or not, you have to observe the changes there. Like this. Okay, and now we will apply this bold, italic, underline. See, bold, so italic, slant, underline, the lines are given here. For this, I don't use underline. For column names, I will give underline. See, okay, like that. And next, this is completed here. And next, alignment. So, which side you want to align? First we will check here for only one record. See, top. Next is middle align, bottom align. So next, for next side, this is horizontal alignment. This is a vertical alignment. Left side, those are moved to left side. Center, center of the cell. This side, right side of the cell. See the difference here and there for first record and second record. Okay. Next one is orientation. See, counterclockwise. Changed or not? Observe the changes. Clockwise direction. This is the clockwise direction. Vertical text. See, vertical it is written PVN here. So next one, rotate text up. So upside it is rotated. Rotate text down. So downside it is rotated. See. So this is the indent. Increase indent. Space is increased between this border and the text. Decrease indent. See again the space is decreased. Again it is displayed in the previous form. So next this one. Wrap text. We will use that here. Okay. Wrap text. We need big sentence. See this much big sentence I wrote here, it is out of the cell, isn't it? See, for that we use first wrap text. We will use wrap text. See how it is displayed. in one single cell it is displayed in multiple lines. That means in two lines it is displayed, but in the single cell. Okay, so this is one, and one more is merchant center. That we will write. Here we will use merchant center. Okay, merchant center. Three cells we had to select. We had to select the merchant center. See, these three cells are combined, and this text is displayed in the middle, in the center of the space. See here. See, it is displayed here. The lines are cutted here. See, those lines are not displayed here. That means total sentence is displayed in one place, combining all the cells. How many cells you have selected, those many cells it will combine, and the text is displayed in the center. Okay, this is useful to write the headings. Suppose here you wrote, now before that you can give the headings: sixth class details, or sixth class student table, sixth class students details, like that. The headings you can write the sentences, and you can use this merchant center for the headings to combine different cells and make it as one, and displaying that sentence in the middle. Okay, for headings you can use this merchant center. So this one. So till here we have completed this one and this one. Okay, alignment also we have checked. This alignments and rotations, wrap text and merge text. So this text formatting also we have checked. Okay, so try it and do one example table and try different colors for that. Try to give these headings. So for this also you can change the color. See here, you can change the color. See, like this you can change. You can change this font color. See the difference, colors are changed or not. Here also you can give, and here also you can select different handwritings. Okay, see different handwritings and different sizes you can select, and you can make it bold, italic, underline also. Okay, so bold, italic, underline, those styles also you can select. Okay children, so like this you can enter table using text formatting and using alignment, using orientation, and this wrap text and merge center. These also on the text only you can work. Okay, all these are in this part. Okay, hope you all understood. Remaining we will learn in next class. Practice one table, either it is student table or employee table or any your friends details. Just keep one heading and give the column names and enter the records. Two or three records are your friends details you can enter, and give different handwritings, give different sizes, make it bold, italic, underline, use this merchant center. Okay, background colors and text colors. Just try it once. Okay children, hope you all understood. Remaining part we will learn in next class.